Well, the African setting is, and our presentation this afternoon is quite different because for us, Rhoda Pistum-Sima, I'm from the African Union Commission, and I'm the commissioner responsible for rural development and agriculture. So in my introductory remarks, I would like to say that, first of all, the highlight of this is on how agriculture links improving food and nutrition security and addressing health challenges. This is a very relevant topic, and I think it is quite overdue. It's an issue which is very important in Africa and which should be considered very critically for advancing the welfare of our population and also the productivity of our workforce. As you all know very well, malnutrition is a major problem in Africa. 1 in 4 people suffer from malnutrition. This is quite high. And 53% of pregnant women in Africa are said to be anemic. The dismal situation with general malnutrition points to worrisome prevalence of micronutrient deficiencies as well. Infectious diseases, which are common and persistent in much of rural sub-Saharan Africa, contribute to a disproportionate burden of mortality among malnourished children. Malnutrition and high incidence and prevalence of diseases negatively impact cognitive development and overall health status of Africa's youth, which will perpetuate the intergenerational cycle of poverty. Although inadequate access to food is just one of the several causal factors for malnutrition, addressing household food insecurity in its diverse manifestations goes a long way towards combating poverty. For Africa, the agricultural linkage at food and nutrition security and health, as well as the roles of the actors, are clearly anchored in the Comprehensive Africa Agricultural Development Program, which is CADAP. CADAP is an African Union-led framework which is aimed at transforming African agriculture through evidence-based and inclusive planning focusing on the full gamut of food and nutrition security, market development, natural resource management, and agricultural research and extension that benefits the majority of the rural population. One of the priority thematic areas under CADAP, and which is of utmost interest to the deliberations here, are encapsulated in Pillar 3, which aims to increase food supply, address nutrition security issues, and improve responses to food emergencies, employing a combination of tried and tested as well as innovative measures, which I hope our panelists today will bring out quite well. CADAP Pillar 3 framework for Africa food security presents the principles that need to be considered in developing food and nutrition, set of interventions, and the menu of options that countries could choose from. It also provides thoughts on some linkages between agriculture, nutrition, and health through some actions, some of which I'll provide here. For example, cereal and oil fortification with vitamin A, iron, folic acid, and multiple nutrients. Then also focusing on production of complementary and therapeutic lipid-based foods, then community-based production and blending of special blended and fortified foods, and accelerated expansion of highly nutritious staples, including orange, fresh, sweet potatoes, red palm oil, and small grains. Most of these, the regional areas are already involved in promoting the same. I would in particular like to draw your attention to the inclusiveness nature of CADAP. CADAP is the in short for the Comprehensive Africa Cultural Development Program. In order to achieve the ideals of CADAP, we expect closer interministerial collaboration in addressing critical issues of hunger, malnutrition, natural resource degradation, and poor market access. CADAP also calls for the engagement of not just government, technical and political leaders, but also civil society organizations in charting the agriculture and food and nutrition agenda of respective countries. We at the African Union Commission believe that this is a new beginning, and indeed a paradigm shift in the way agriculture and food security planning is formulated in Africa. As I indicated, CADAP provides the required tools and instruments to help countries in Africa reorient their respective agriculture and food security investment plans in ways that would benefit the majority of the population at the same time accelerating growth as a precondition for further broad-based development. And importantly, as part of CADAP review, that is of country agriculture and food security investment plans, advice and support is provided to countries that ensure that there are specific food and nutrition strategies with responsibilities for their implementation shared between ministries of agriculture, health, and other important sectors, such as education. As in all these facets of life, the changes we are spearheading here do not always meet with enthusiasm, because working together is not easy. For development planning in Africa over the decades, it has been pursued along strict sectoral lines with little or no appreciation of the synergies that could be realized from employing an integrated planning approach, which through the discussions we have been having since we came, I think has been stressed. The good news is that CADAP has started catalyzing changes in this sphere as well. For example, all the 24 countries that have signed CADAP compacts, that is the commitment documents with identified investment priority areas, they have all indicated achievement of food and nutrition security as top priority. This poses both a challenge and opportunity to all of us here, including the political leaders who may be here, policymakers, the research community, which I've seen here, the civil society, and our other partners. I would like this panel, which is before you, in their discussion, to provide us with further thoughts on how best we could capitalize on the gains of this reorientation in the agricultural program planning, so that the complementarities and synergies between agriculture, nutrition, and health are realized at the implementation stage. In this way, this will empower different relevant line ministries and pertinent civil society organizations in delivering their desired results. As part of taking forward this CADAP strategic framework for increasing agriculture production and productivity, food and nutrition security together with health, the African Union launched the Africa Day for Food and Nutrition Security, a day that will be celebrated annually on the 30th October to raise awareness and renew multi-stakeholder efforts towards improving food and nutrition security. Of course, this is just a summary of it, but the day has a lot of details. However, in order for our research and advocacy work to be of real value to our own populations in Africa, best practices obtained through implementing development projects, as well from the time-tested indigenous practices of the diverse African cultures, need to be synthesized and made available to program planners. This will go a long way towards a better understanding of household behavior in Africa in relation to the dynamics of food availability, nutrition deficiency, and health improvement. Policymakers need to work on providing countries with the knowledge of these practices and resources to upscale them. Commonly cited best practices include the promotion of exclusive breastfeeding for at least 6 months, targeted micronutrient interventions, that is vitamin A and iron, for pregnant women, micronutrient fortification and supplementation. The question is, how can policymakers under different institutions work together to deliver these proven services at scale? CADAP provides the platform for strengthening the capacity of non-state actors, I said earlier on, farmers' organizations, CSOs, private sector, academia, so as to ensure that these key domestic constituencies understand the multifaceted linkages between agriculture and nutrition and health outcomes. The platforms CADAP provide at country level are also believed to serve as advocacy fora for diversification of agricultural practices, as well as education for ensuring adequate nutritional foods for better health. A key challenge, however, for the deliberations in this panel is how to reorganize agricultural research and extension, as well as the rural service delivery system at large, so as to realize both increased food production and improved nutritional and health outcomes.